Hello students, in the previous video we understood the meaning of electric charge. We also understood the three basic properties of electric charge and we did the numerical based on the same topic. And I hope you understood the topic. And still, if you have any doubt related with the previous video or the topic, you are free to ask the question. Because the topic we are going to study today is related with your previous topic. So the topic we have today is electric current. We'll talk about electric current. We'll understand the flow of electric current in a circuit, the condition for the flow of current, how the electric current is related with the electric charge and time. So at the end of this particular topic, we will be able to calculate the electric current flowing in a circuit based on the number of charges. Or we will be able to calculate the number of charges flowing in a circuit based on the electric current. So let's start the topic now. So let's start now. That is the chapter we have electricity, and the topic we are going to discuss today is electric current. So the very first, we are going to start with the concept of electric current only. And as you can see here, we are writing capital I for the electric current. That is just the symbol for the current. So don't be confused with the SI unit. I is not the SI unit of the current. So very first, before I give the explanation, you can read it. Read the statement given here. The electric current is the flow of electric charge for which the carriers are required. Electric charge is the carrier of electric energy, and hence more is the amount of electric charge, more will be the flow of electric energy, and hence more will be the electric current. So let's understand the meaning. The simple concept we have is overall electric current is nothing but the flow of electric energy within the conductor. And for the flow of this electric energy, we need some particles which can carry the electric energy from one to the other end of the conductor. And for this, we have the charged particles, or we can say the free charges we have within the conductor, which are responsible for the flow of electric energy within the conductor. So it is understood, if we increase the amount of charge flowing through the conductor, automatically the amount of electric energy flowing through the conductor will increase, and hence electric current will also increase. So we can say here that overall electric current is proportional to the electric charge. More is the amount of charge flowing through the conductor, more will be the electric current in the conductor. So I is proportional to electric charge. We got the very first concept. Second concept, that is the current flowing through the conductor is also related with the time for which the electric charge will flow. In simple language, we can say the charges which are flowing through the conductor, they will have different speed. If the speed of flow is high, then it is understood more energy will be transferred in less time, and hence more will be the current. So we can say if the time taken for the flow of charge is less, more will be the current, and vice versa. So in simple language, we can say I, or the electric current, is also depending on the time. That is, it is inversely proportional to the time. And combining this first and second, what we are getting, I is proportional to Q upon T. Or finally, we are getting the equation I is equal to Q by T. So this is the final equation we have, or we can say final formula we have for the electric current. That is I is equal to Q upon T, and based on this we can define the electric current now. So we can say electric current is the flow of electric charge per unit time in a conductor, or we can say rate of flow of electric charge through the conductor. Okay, so I hope definition is also clear. So you can see also electric current can be defined as the rate of flow of electric charge through cross sectional area of the conductor.
Cross section is, I think, clear to you. Any conductor, if you take and if you cut the conductor in two parts, the dividing area will be the cross section through which the charge basically flows. So I hope this topic, this definition is clear to you and the concept also. Now we are moving to the next thing, that is SI unit of electric charge, sorry, electric current. So we know in physics any SI unit of any physical quantity we basically do with the help of formula. So since you got the SI unit of since we got the formula of electric current, that is Q by T, and we know the SI unit of charge, that is Coulomb, we know the SI unit of time, that is second. So dividing this, what we'll get? H is equal to, sorry, I equal to Q by T, that is Coulomb per second, or 1 Coulomb per second is basically equal to 1 ampere. So ampere and Coulomb per second, they are the same thing, but in general we use capital A or the ampere for the electric current SI unit. So I hope it is clear, the SI unit of electric current also. And based on this concept, we have the question now. Define SI unit of electric current. Such questions we have done in class 9th also. And the very simple concept we have, if we have to define the SI unit of any physical quantity, what we do? We define one means, for example, we are going to define the SI unit of electric current. So SI unit of electric current is ampere, and we have to define 1 ampere. So this can be done with the help of the formula. We know I is equal to Q by T, and if we take charge as 1 coulomb and time of flow of charge is 1 second, then dividing 1 by 1, what we'll get? 1 ampere. And based on this we can define, that is, if 1 coulomb of electric charge will flow through cross section of conductor in 1 second, then electric current flowing in the conductor will be 1 ampere. So this is how we can define the SI unit of electric current also. And now we'll just do some numerical based on the understanding of the electric current. And the very first question we have, if n electrons flow through cross section of conductor in time t, then find the electric current. So what is given to us? That is number of electrons n, total time t, and what we have to find? Total current flowing in the conductor. So we know very simple thing, concept that we have done in the previous topic, that is Q is equal to Ne. So since we know the number of electrons flowing through the conductor is N, so we can find total charge flowing through the conductor, that is Ne. And then we know how to find the electric current, that is Q upon T. So Q will become Ne and time will become T only, because it is given T. So finally we got the answer, I is equal to Ne upon T, where E is the charge of one electron, but we are not going to put any values here because no values are given. So this is the final answer. Now the next question we have, that is, if 2 ampere current flows through a conductor for 1 minute, find the total number of electrons that will flow in that time. So in this case, the total current flowing through the conductor is given, that is 2 ampere. And if this current will flow through the conductor for 1 minute, then in this much time, that is 1 minute, how many charges will flow through the conductor, we need to find out. So things given to us, current 2 ampere, time is given 1 minute, but must be converted into second because SI unit of time is second. And we have to find N. So very first, what we can do, we can find the total charge that will flow in this much time, and then we can find total number of electrons. So total charge will be Q is equal to I into T, because I is equal to Q upon T, and putting the values 2 into 60, we are getting 120 coulomb. So 120 coulomb charge will flow through this given conductor in 1 minute. And since we got the total charge flowing through the conductor, we can also find total number of electrons that will flow. using the concept of quantization of charge, that is Q is equal to Ne. So Q is equal to Ne and will become Q upon E. Q we have already calculated 120, and the value of E we know, that is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. Solving it, we are getting 75 into 10 to the power 19 electrons. So we can say in this much time, this number of electrons will flow through the conductor. I hope it is clear. And number 3 we have, third numerical. It is given, if 20 milliampere current flows through the conductor for 2 minutes, then find the total electric charge that will flow in this time. So in this case, the current is given in some other unit, that is milliampere. Small m is for milli and capital is ampere. And this current will flow through the conductor in for time 2 minutes. And based on this, we have to find out how much charge will flow. In this case, we are not going to find the number of electrons. We just need to find the charge. So this numerical is given just to understand the meaning of milliampere, and rest thing are same. So we should know milli basically means 10 to the power minus 3. So if current is given in milliampere, we need to convert into ampere. So that is 20 milliampere will be 20 into 10 to the power minus 3 ampere, and time should be converted into second, that is 120 seconds. And finally we know I is equal to Q upon T, so Q will be I into T, and solving it we are getting 2.4 coulomb. So we can say in time 2 minutes the total charge that will flow, that is quantity of the charge that will flow through this conductor, will be 2.4 coulomb. And in this case we are not going to find the number of electrons, but still if you want to find, you can apply the formula Q is equal to Ne and you can get the answer. So only thing you should know, milli 10 to the power minus 3, if it is given micro, the current is in micro ampere, so micro is 10 to the power minus 6. So this values you should know, because the numerical can come based on this unit also. And the fourth one and the last one given to you, which says the current the 50 coulomb milli coulomb, in this case if 50 milli coulomb of electric charge flows through the cross section of a conductor in 2 seconds, find the current flowing through the conductor, and write and explain any two ways by which the electric current can be made doubled in the conductor at the same temperature. So the very first part is, the charge is given in milli coulomb, you need to convert into coulomb. Time is given in second only, so no need to convert, and based on this we have to find the electric current. So we know it's very simple. The only thing is, you need to convert the unit of electric charge. And the second part is, you have to explain any two factors or the method by which we can make the current double in the same conductor at the same temperature. Means we are not going to change the conductor, we are not going to change the temperature of the atmosphere, but then also if we have to make this current double, then what can be done? So this is to be done by you. This question will not be solved by me, try it yourself. And still if you have any doubt, you can ask, but I hope this topic is clear, and that is the end of this topic today. Go through this video again if you have not understood it properly, and even if you get any doubt at the end, let me know, I'll be answering all the questions.